Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. Myself Tejashree Shisagar, and this year I am going to teach you biology. Okay, so from the biology today we will start the first lesson, that is nutrition in plants. Okay, so in that lesson we will see how the plants are taking their food, which are the ways or which are the modes in that the plants are taking their food. Okay, so without wasting any time, let's move for the first point of the lesson. So in the nutrition of the plant, first we will discuss about the nutrients. So what is mean by nutrients? In your previous classes you have discussed about there are the different components of the food. So which are the components of the food? Yes, correct. Carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals, all these are called as components of the food, and that components of the foods are called as nutrients. Okay, so the nutrients is nothing but what? All the components that we are adding in our diet, that we are getting from our diet, that components of the food are called as nutrients. So these nutrients are necessary for each and every living organism on the earth. For each and every living organism requires the nutrients for their specific body activities or to perform the different life processes. Now different life processes, like we can say that breathing is there, respiration is there, excretion is there, circulation in our body is there, reproduction is there. So there are the certain processes are going on in our body, and to perform all that processes smoothly or neatly, our body requires the energy, and that energy we are getting from the different nutrients. Also these nutrients keeps our body healthy, provides energy and also keeps our body healthy. It maintains our body. And one of the main importance of the nutrient is that it helps to repair our body, wear and tear of the body. Now repair of the body means what? Sometime what happens, the cuts are happens on our body, but after the time pass out, that cuts get healed without our knowing. So how it get heals? Because of certain nutrients which helps to repair our damaged cell or to damaged tissues. So in this way we require the nutrients. Or why there is a necessity of the food? Because from the food we are getting the nutrients. And why this food or the nutrients is necessary for our body? To get energy, to keep our body healthy, to maintain the body, or to repair the damaged cell of the body, to repair our body system. So in this way each and every living organism requires the nutrients. But if we will talk about the living things, there are the plants, animals and human beings. All these are the living things. Okay, and in that all living things, the plants are the living things which makes their own food. So the plants are the things, or the plants are the living things which makes their own food. But there are the different ways in that ways the plants are making their food. Okay, so let's discuss for the modes of nutrition in plants. Okay, so how the plants is getting the nutrition, which are the ways, which are the types in that the plants is getting their nutrition. So let's see, before going to see that, we'll discuss about the nutrition. So what is mean by nutrition? Nutrition is the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization by the body. So what is mean by the nutrition? Nutrition is what? Nothing but the taking the food by an living organism, and after that taking food, how that food is get utilized by our body. So as we know, after eating the food, there are so many processes going on in our body. There is digestion, there is absorption, and from that our body is getting energy, and that energy is get utilized by the body. So the taking of food by an organism and its utilization by the body is nothing but what? Nutrition. That process is called as nutrition. So in the plants there are the two modes of nutrition. Okay, so let's discuss for that. There are the two types of the nutrition in the plants, which are, first one is their autotrophic and the second one is their heterotrophics. So let's discuss about the autotrophic mode of nutrition. So autotrophic, so that word says itself, or the word explains itself, that is auto means what? Self. And trops means nourishment, or we can say the nutrition. Auto means self, trop means nourishment, or we can say the nutrition. So the living organisms which can make their own food by using the raw materials like water, minerals, sunlight, carbon dioxide, by using all that raw materials, the living organisms can mix their own food. That mode of the nutrition is called as autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, or in a simple language we can say that, simple words we can say that, the living organism, those can mix their own food. For their food, they are not depends on anyone. They can mix their own food. That living organism or that mode of nutrition is called as autotrophic nutrition. So as we know, on the earth there is only one living thing which makes their own food by using the raw material, that is nothing but plants. Okay, so the plants are showing the autotrophic mode of nutrition, and that's why the plants are called as autotrophs. Okay, again I will repeat, the living organisms, those who are showing autotrophic mode of nutrition, the living organism, those who are showing autotrophic mode of nutrition, that living organisms are called as autotrophs. Okay, and who is showing the autotrophic mode of nutrition? Examples are green plants, and there are the certain bacteria, those who are also showing the autotrophic mode of nutrition. So these green plants makes their own food, and that's why they are called as autotrophs. Okay, now we will move further or the next mode of nutrition, that is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So let's discuss about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Hetero means other, and troph means nourishment or nutrition. Okay, hetero means other, trops means nourishment. Okay, means what? For their nourishment, for their nutrition, they are depends on other. Okay, or we can say that the living organism, those who cannot make their own food by using the raw material, or they have to depends on other, they are getting the ready made food, that living organisms are, or that mode of nutrition is called as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, again I will explain the word. Hetero means what? Other, and troph means nourishment or nutrition. Means we can say that the organisms, the living organisms, those who cannot make their own food, for their food they are depends on other, that mode of nutrition is called as what? Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. And the organisms, those who are showing the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, that organisms are called as heterotrophs. Okay, that organisms are called as heterotrophs. And the examples of the heterotrophs are non-green plants and animals. So these are the examples of heterotrophs, because for their food, for their nourishment purpose, for their nutrition purpose, they are depends on other, and that's why they are called as heterotrophs. So non-green plants and animals are the heterotrophs. So let's revise what we have discussed today. We have seen that nutrients means what? The components of the foods are called as nutrients. Nutrition means what? Nutrition is the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization by the body. There are the two modes of nutrition in the plant. First one is autotrophic, second one is heterotrophic. Autotrophic means what? They can make their own food, for their food they are not depends on any one. Example is green plants, and that's why they are called as autotrophs, because they make their own food. Next one is heterotrophy, means what? For their nourishment purpose, they depends on other that organisms. Those who are showing heterotrophy, they are called as heterotrophs. Examples are non-green plants and animals. So this is all about today. So today I will end my class. Next point or next section we will see in our next lecture. For today, thank you.